Excellencies, in the Philippines, education has always been given priority. No less than our constitution provides that the highest level of spending in the national budget has to be for education. However, the disruption of economic activities within and across countries has resulted in intense competition for resources among sectors and agencies of government for adjustment and recovery reasons. In this intense competition, education is placed at a disadvantage amidst the emergence of health, social amelioration, and economic recovery drivers as key priorities for adjustment and recovery finance. Therefore, the challenge for us in the education sector is to defend continuity of learning, and we are doing all we can. We have a two-pronged approach to education. One is to emphasize that learning delivery in a safe manner is still possible, COVID notwithstanding. Secondly, we show that safe learning continuity in the time of COVID constitutes necessary and sound investment for education transformation in the future. Our school system resumed the learning process, and we welcomed 22.6 million children for the opening of our school year for 2021, an enrollment which is higher than the enrollment level in public schools last year. Another 2.2 million learners from private schools have already started in our schools as well. And so this has not been a small feat, and there will be equity and quality losses, but there will be more equity and quality gains. Thank you, Excellencies.